This crane design became popular a number of years ago, and for good reason. Let's see how it works. So we have this 10,000 pound I-beam hanging off the end of it, and we have this 50,000 pound counterweight that will act to balance it, okay? So we're asked to find the distance x of the counterweight for zero torque at the base of the crane. So an engineer years ago said, if we take this counterweight and we put it on a track, then we can adjust how far away from the spine of the crane that we want the counterweight to be so that we can balance any size weight that we want to put over here. You know, within reason, of course. And so, you know, if you have a very heavy object, then you put the counterweight further away from the spine of the crane. But if you have a light object, then you put the counterweight closer to the spine of the crane. And this was the utility of this design. So we're going to assume that the crane is initially balanced, right? With no I-beam, that the crane is initially balanced, right? Okay, so let's take a look at it. Here's the free body diagram. So for balance to occur, we want zero torque at the base of the crane, right? Now zero torque at the base of the crane is the same as having zero torque all along the spine of the crane. So zero torque all along the spine of the crane. Because notice that the perpendicular moment arm that causes the torque, right, that is used to calculate the torque is the same for, you know, from the point of action to any point on the spine. And the same is true for on this side, right? So we say the sum of the torques are equal to zero, sigma tau, like this. So the 50,000 pound weight has a tendency to cause counterclockwise rotation, so we say that is a positive torque by convention. So torque equals force times distance, so we have positive 50,000 times x. Minus because this 10,000 pound weight here has a tendency to cause clockwise rotation, and by convention we call those negative torques. So minus 10,000 times 100 feet, right? Notice that the height of the crane doesn't factor into the calculation whatsoever. So minus 10,000 times 100. And that's, of course, equal to zero. And x, if we solve for x, x is equal to 20 feet. Okay? So whenever x is equal to 20 feet, the crane just balances there. And very little support is needed at the base of the crane. Okay, see you next time.